What's up? Welcome to the courtroom.
I am Theo.
And I'm Oj. And in this podcast, we tell stories about people's life, liberty, and property.
Kukwentohan namin kayo about court rulings in a way that will make you understand jurisprudence like a 9-year-old.
All persons before the Honorable Supreme Court of Justice shall hear their attention for the court now in session.
So join us as we delve into true crime, political controversies, and all things tatay de chismis every week. In 1950, Tita Villanueva became pregnant by her boyfriend Oscar Lazo dahil gustong itago ni Nita ang pagbubuntis niya sa parents niya, and acting na din on the advice of her tita, she decided to terminate her pregnancy.
Paula Yambot was the name of her tita, right?
Mm-hmm. And bakit kilala mo? Close kayo?
Hindi, nabasa ko yung full text. Ah. And dahil nga, advice na din ni Tita Paula na magpa-abort si Nita, pinakilala na din sa kanya nung tita niya si Dr. Antonio Geluz so that she can seek for his assistance for the said abortion.
Time passed and Nita and Oscar got married. As what's expected for a husband and wife, their love bore them another child.
And during that time, Nita was still employed in the Commission on Elections or COMELEC. And medyo inconvenient for her yung pregnancy, so she had herself aborted again by the same abortionist, si Dr. Antonio, in October 1953.
Kaso, on February 21, 1955, wala pang 2 taon mula nung huli siyang nagpalaglag sa second child niya, nabuntis na naman itong si Nita. Again, naisipan na naman niyang ipalaglag ang bata.
Pangatlo na to, ah, kasama niya pa dito yung sister niya, si Purification, pati yung pamangkin niya, si Lucida. Pumunta ulit sila sa clinic ni Dr. Antonio.
San kaya tong clinic na to, no?
Sa kanto daw to sa Carriedo and P. Gomez sa Manila.
Kakahalata na ako, kilala mo si Paula, tapos alam mo yung clinic, ah.
Hindi nga kasi, totoo. Nagbasa nga ako ng full text, totoo. Although, 1950 case to, eh. Ewan ko kung andun pa yung clinic
basta
na yun.
Basta kaanumalyahan, alam nito eh. No? So, okay. Ayun, pumunta nga si Nita sa clinic ni Dr. Antonio and doon sinalubong siya nito kasama ang kanyang asawa. And this time, Nita aborted a 2-month-old fetus for a sum of 50 pesos. Nasa Cagayan daw nung mga time na to si Oscar campaigning for his election to the provincial board. So, he did not know nor give consent to the abortion during this time. And ito na din naman ang huling abortion na ginawa ni Nita.
The third and last abortion. Ito yung ginawang basis ni Oscar, yung husband ni Nita, in filing an action and award for damages na pinabara naman ng lower court. They ordered Dr. Antonio to pay 3,000 pesos as damages, 700 pesos, attorney's fees, and the cost of the suit. Mukhang malit, no? Pero remember, courtmates, 1950 case to. And malaking pera na yan that time.
Tama. Sinubukang umapela ni Dr. Antonio sa Court of Appeals but a 3-2 vote sustained the award against him. Kaya naman, Dr. Antonio filed a petition for certiorari to bring the case to the Supreme Court.
Question. Can a husband of a woman who voluntarily procured her abortion recover damages from the abortionist doctor?
Well, yan ang tanong sa kasong to and sabi ng Supreme Court, hindi daw.
So, mali ang lower court?
Well, sabi ng Supreme Court, correct ka daw. Yung award daw kasi na 3,000 for damages was based on the initial paragraph of Article 2206 of the Civil Code. Kaso daw, yung said provision ng batas na ito fixing a minimum amount or minimum award of 3,000 for the death of a person does not cover the case of unborn fetus kasi nga wala pa daw itong civil personality.
Civil personality? Paki-explain, ano tong civil personality na to?
Well, civil personality is the aptitude of being the subject of rights and obligations. Pag may civil personality ka, edi fit ka to be the subject of legal relations or you have the power to do acts with legal effect.
Like filing a case, isa to sa mga actions that can produce a legal effect, right?
Oo.
So, as per Supreme Court, the fetus never acquired personality because it was never born. It was not alive at the time it was delivered from the mother's womb. And dahil nga, the fetus did not acquire any personality, it is incapable of having rights and obligations. In short, no personality, no rights and obligations.
Sabi din ng court, hindi din daw pwede gamitin dito ang Article 40 of the Civil Code.
Ano ba sabi sa Article 40?
It stated that birth determines personality, but the conceived child shall be considered born for all purposes that are favorable to it.
Ina-argue kasi nila na, di ba, birth determines personality daw, and yung conceived child may be considered born daw under Article 40. Kaso nga, may caveat to that condition. Kasi stated din sa Article 40 na yung conceived child shall be considered born provided it be born later with the conditions specified in Article 41.
Ano nga ba yung mga conditions para masabi na conceived child o yung pinagbubuntis pa lang eh meron ng personality?
Well, dapat yung conceived child is alive at the time it is completely delivered from the mother's womb. Meaning, buhay pa yung bata when the umbilical cord was cut. So, habang nasa tiyan pa siya ng mom niya, the conceived child acquires provisional personality. Provisional lang because it depends upon the child being born alive later. And since provisional pa lang, its personality is essentially limited.
Although, if the fetus had a intrauterine life of less than 7 months, meaning yung mga premature babies, it is not deemed born if it dies within 24 hours after its complete delivery from the maternal womb. Meaning, if premature pinanganak pero hindi umabot ng 24 hours, namatay, walang personality na na-acquire pag ganon. But if it expired or yung baby expired after 24 hours from the time the umbilical cord was cut, then provisional personality is acquired.
In this case, the aborted fetus did not meet any of the two conditions because the fetus was dead when separated from Nita's womb. Given that, it never acquired personality. And without a personality nga, the fetus acquired no rights which could be transmitted to Oscar. Kaya naman, Oscar could not sue in a representative capacity. Kasi diba, sa abortion, ang pinaka-affected talaga is yung fetus na i-a-abort. So, hypothetically, yung fetus dapat yung mag-file ng kaso. Eh, alam naman natin, imposible yun. So, as a representative, at least yung parents yung magkakaso.
Kaso nga, diba, walang right yung fetus kasi wala siyang personality.
Yes, kaya nga, wala siyang na-transmit na right kay Oscar kasi wala naman right na itatransmit in the first place.
Pero hindi naman ibig sabihin that parents are not entitled to collect any damages at all. Pwede pa rin naman, but such damages must be those inflicted directly upon them and not the injury or violation to the rights of the deceased. According to Article 2217 of the Civil Code, the relief of parents shall be limited to moral damages on account of distress and anguish, to the loss of the child, and disappointment of the parental expectation, or pwede din namang exemplary damages under 2230 of the Civil Code.
Although sa case, both moral and exemplary damage were not granted to Oscar and Nita.
Bakit? Kala ko ba pwedeng i-award sa parents to who lost their child?
Pwede nga, on account of the anguish they suffered. But in this case, the court found Oscar's indifference to the previous abortions of Nita as clear indication that he was unconcerned with the frustration of his parental hopes and affections. Meaning, based sa actuations or reactions niya, mukhang wala naman talaga siyang pake if mawalan siya ng anak.
Apparently, Oscar was aware of the second abortion and the probabilities are aware din siya doon malamang sa first abortion. Yet, despite the conscious repetition of the event, wala siyang ginawa to step up and investigate nor pinpoint the cause of this abortion.
Yun nga. Other than that, he didn't pursue na maparusahan si Dr. Antonio. After niya malaman yung about dun sa third abortion, instead of pressing administrative and criminal cases against the abortionist doctor, he opted to just pursue a civil action for damages. And sino ba yung magbe-benefit if manalo siya sa gantong case? Siyempre, pareho sila ng wife niya na si Nita.
The court observed na yung reaction daw ni Oscar is not normal for a husband who righteously feel outraged by the abortion. Kasi instead na yung primary concern niya is to see that the medical profession was purged of an unworthy member such as Dr. Antonio, mukhang mas priority niya is to obtain large sum of money and turn his wife's indiscretion to personal profit.
Pero syempre, despite that, hindi pa din lusot si Dr. Antonio. I mean, lusot siya in terms of the civil case for damages filed by Oscar. But his act of provoking abortion without medical necessity was deemed as a criminal offense. And kahit pa may consent yung woman or that of her husband, it is not an excuse for that morally reprehensible act. So in that view, hindi siya lusot. So a copy of the decision was ordered to be sent to the Department of Justice and the Board of Medical Examiners for investigation and filing of appropriate action against the abortionist doctor.
In the end, sabi ng Supreme Court, the immorality or illegality of the act does not justify an award of damages that have no factual or legal basis. Kaya naman, the decision was reversed and the complaint of Oscar was dismissed without cost.
If you guys like this audiogram, please listen to the full episode on Spotify or on your favorite podcast app, where you can hear our insights on this case. Again, this is Oj.
And Teo, leaving you with a reminder to always look back in history, because precedent shall rule the future.
Thank you for listening, and we'll see you again in the courtroom.
Bye!